G21, G17, G90, G80, G54. Oh, hello there. You just caught me refreshing myself on how to program a part using G-codes, the ISO standard that a lot of machinists and programmers started their career journey using. All I can say is thank goodness for conversational programming systems, like we have fitted on the ProtoTRAK control that XYZ had been fitting since the early 90s. This system makes it so friendly and easy to use when you're typically doing 2.5D parts like the samples here for profiles, pocket and drill features. And with its auto geometry engine feature, even if the draftsman hasn't given you all the intersections and tangent points, it makes programming of your shape still possible. But if you get your drawings electronically, the ProtoTRAK can also accept DXF and Parasolid files, so it means you're working directly from the electronic file, so therefore there's no errors in programming when you write these parts. But gradually over the last few years, we've seen a rise in people investing in CAM packages. Whether that's because they've become subscription-based and therefore the cost is per month, we're not sure. And if you're doing 3D style of work, then maybe a CAM package is worth the investment. And if it is, these CAM packages churn out a program through the post-processor using G-codes. But if that's what you're using and you think, oh, I can't look at the ProtoTRAK control system because it won't accept G-codes, well, that's not true, as we're about to find out. Modern CAD CAM packages are very easy to learn and use these days. Being able to create jobs from solid models, adding all the sort of features that you need to make your part, a lot of people are now investing in this process. By then moving on to CAM side of things, where you can select the right tools to do the processes, select your feeds and speeds, deciding on the depths of cut that you want, creating a cutter path is usually very simple. Once the cutter path has been created, most of these packages allow you to go in, do a simulation to check that you've done everything correctly, there's no gouging, all of the machining parts are made correctly. Once the simulation is completed, most users then move on to the final part of the jigsaw, which is to use a post-processor for the correct controller and generate the G-code program. Once this G-code program is created, the program can be saved then to a USB or to a PC that's networked to the control. So when your G-code program has been post-processed, we can now load it into the ProtoTRAK. And we are given two options here. We can actually call on our program the extension .cam. With a CAM file, when we open the file, what the ProtoTRAK controller will do is it will convert the G-code data into ProtoTRAK's conversational software version. So when the program has been loaded in, we can now enter the programming mode and we will see now the familiar text that we get if we've programmed in ProtoTRAK. For example, mill events are displayed with X and Y begins, ends, centers, feed rates, etc, etc. So anybody that's had training on the ProtoTRAK would understand this language. But on this 3D program, with 72,503 lines, that's a lot of data to take into the control and convert. So the second option that we have is the ability to open the G-code program as a .gcd. The difference between this and the CAM option is that when we open a GCD, it doesn't do a conversion into ProtoTRAK's own language. The control is going to run the pure narrative G-code that's been written by the CADCAM package. We can still, if we wish to, go in and do our tool check-in by using toolpath, so we lose none of the verification features that the control delivers to us. And as well as being able to watch the toolpath, if we put our tool data in, we can go in and we can use the verify feature. But if during verification or even running of the program you find an error and you need to make a subtle change to the program, you don't have to return back to the office and re-post process to make that change. By selecting Edit on the control, and then using the function G-code Edit at the bottom of the screen, the program will appear in a notepad format, and then using the touchscreen, highlight the section that needs to be modified and make the change without having to go away from the machine. We hope we've been able to show you another element of the ProtoTRAK then control that makes it flexible for today's modern workshop. Programming up the shop floor on the machine or purchasing the offline for the system means that you can program away from the machine in the office or even at home if you want. But it can also take in the DXF, the Parasolid and the G-code program. If you'd like to learn more about how flexible the ProtoTRAK system is and you want to arrange a desktop demo at your facility or visit one of our showrooms located around the country, give us a call, send us an email or look up more details on the website.